Alright, so we're back with the engine. We're gonna start working on it, start trying to take off the head. I've never worked on the engine before, only like stuff surrounding it and stuff like that. So all this is a learning process. So if you guys see that I'm doing something wrong, let me know. And seems like it's leaking already. So yep, it's confirmed, it's a Honda. So let's take out the valve cover real quick. Well, I'm gonna put my gloves on first. I got them on. The guy didn't have the original things that go right here to hold the valve cover, so he just found these real quick at his house, so they won't, so the valve cover won't fly away in the freeway. Honestly, we didn't even have this engine strapped up, and there was about a 60 mile drive. Damn, that's ain't no good. So I'm gonna just take off the valve cover right now. So I took off the valve cover, I took off the cam cover right here. It was just two 12s, and these little ones were 12s too that were on the valve cover. So now I got what is this, 3/4, and now that fits in. I tested a little bit by turning it, it does turn. So I'm gonna put it atop dead center. As you can see, it's not in top dead center, so I have to put this up and then something else, a tooth I think, but I'll figure out as I go and I'll just keep you updated. So here it is, top dead center, they're both up, and there's that tooth that I was talking about. So when I was taking off the timing belt, when I was sliding it off, it would move the cams a little bit, and so it would throw off like the tooth. So pretty much what I did was, when it was like halfway off, or like when it was like around here, I would just realign it to the top dead center and then just slowly take it off so it could have stayed top dead center. So now I'm gonna work on taking these covers off, and almost just search up like the sequence, or because I know you have to do like a certain pattern or something. So I'll try to find that out right now. So we're gonna start with this one. This is number one. Actually, hold on. Just wanna make sure. I'm gonna start with this one, it's gonna be number one. Let's get that in. And I have it on the jack, so it's gonna move. So that's one. And I moved the whole engine. Two. I'm only gonna break them with my breaker bar. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. 9, 10, and then the last two are 10 mils, it seems like it. So let me get that real quick. I just repeat the same process for this side, and these covers should be out. I have them here now. I labeled them pretty much exhaust side and then intake side. I put each one where I got it from the engine, like it's, this is how I came out, this is how I'm gonna put it in, hopefully, if I don't get it mixed up. Now I'm gonna do the same for these right here. The, what are they called? Caps, I think? Cam caps? I don't know. If I get the name wrong, I'll just put it up in the screen or something. But so I'm gonna take these off, take all of them off, and line them up exactly the same with the rest that I have over there lined up. And we'll go from there. everything set up the way it's supposed to go back in, the way I took it out, the way it's going back in. Here's everything. Here's the cams if you guys want to see. That stuff is just like my shop towels that I have that are kind of cheap from Harbor Freight. So I was leaving. Gotta make sure to clean everything up again before I put it in, or before I put it back into the head, because I'm still not sure if I'm gonna use that head. Hopefully my head's fine. I'll just continue using mine. So that's the progress so far. I think all there is to do now is to take out the head studs, pretty much. And then I could take the head off, the whole head and the intake manifold together. So I'll get to that. All right, so I'm pretty much just get to work. I'm not gonna do a little time lapse for this one, so I'll just tell you the sequence. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. That's the sequence, and I was reading to prevent warp of the head or the lock, to turn it up 1/3 at a time for each one, for the whole sequence, 1/3 at a time. So like, keep doing it until it loosens. It's just to save your engine pretty much from warping. So I'm gonna just get to it, and then once I'm starting to take off the head, I'll start recording again. All right, the head studs are out right here. Have them all how they came out as well, top bottom, you know. So the head's ready to come out now. I don't know how heavy it is. I don't have anyone helping me here. I should have probably taken off the manifold. Who knows? We'll see. I'm probably gonna maybe leave it up here. I'll just like cover it, make sure. Or maybe on this chair, I'll probably leave it right here. Cover it up and then put the head right there so I could start seeing what's up with the block and stuff. It is, took the head off. So here's the pistons. They don't look that gunky. They're not like, this one's pretty clean, honestly. This one doesn't have much carbon. All right, here, I'll turn on the flash on my phone really quick. Now you can see better. So you could see there, there's that piston. This one has very little carbon buildup. And this one's the worst one, I'd say. The two outer ones are the worst ones. Two middle ones, this one's a little gunked up, and then this one's pretty clean. All right, so all I've done so far is taking out the breather box, because I run a catch can, and I took out this right here. That connects to the breather box through right here. In my Integra, since I did the breather box with the engine in the car, obviously, this gets really hard to get to because of this manifold. It blocks everything. It blocks this one, it blocks, or not blocks, but it makes it super hard to get to these. So like for this one, I had to use like a blade and scissors to take it off from this. So, and it's off the car, so imagine being in the car, and it sucks. So better do it now while it's out, and before I go get it built and whatever I'm gonna do with it, still not sure yet. So I did this. The breather box took me a while to get out because I was doing it from up here, so I couldn't see what was happening. I know it's just one bolt which I took off, but there was this bracket right here, so it was blocking. So this little bracket right here was behind this one, so it wouldn't let me take it out because it was like right here. Until I came under over here and saw that this bracket was in the way, so I took that off. It was bolted right here, I think. I don't know what that's for. I don't think mine had it. But, I mean, the block looks good. Everything's good. I mean, it's just a rod knock, but that's inside that we have to check. And so I just took off this for now. I'm gonna have to put my block off from my block. I'm gonna have to take these off again, put the lines again. Or damn, I think I'm gonna have to get different lines. Someone told me to get different lines because since the engine blew, there's probably gonna be metal shavings all over my lines. So I'm gonna have to probably check on those lines. I'm gonna have to remove this again to put my feed line, which I'm gonna replace also because there might be metal shavings inside. And just, yeah, a whole bunch of stuff to do. I want to get a rear main seal. So once I have a chance, I'm gonna go to Acura, get a rear main seal, replace that while I'm at it, and just do stuff. I don't know what I'm doing, honestly, but at least I got the block to how it is right now, so I could see where I'm gonna take it now already. I want to get this running. I want to get my car running at least within 3 weeks, hopefully. Like, the longest process is gonna be like if they're gonna machine the block, however long they're gonna take, or if I'm gonna send it to get built by someone, because I don't want to mess with that. But I'll see videos, I'll see online to see how hard it is to build the block itself, like pistons, rods, what I'm gonna get. It doesn't seem too hard, then I wouldn't mind trying it myself, but we'll see what happens. This is where I'm gonna leave this video. This is another part of the rebuilding process of my Integra. So this is where I'm gonna end off the video. And this is a 97, if you guys were wondering. Well, not 97. I don't get it, because on mine, yeah, mine's a 99 Integra, and mine right here, it says 98. And this one was off a 98, so it says 97. So I'm guessing like they made the engine like the year before or something. I don't know. But yeah, I'm gonna just put the head somewhere safe. Or I'll probably show you guys right now under. See how the valves are and stuff. I'll just like turn it over or something real quick and show you guys, and then I'll just end off the video. All right, so here's the valves. They don't look that bad. Then again, I don't know what good or bad valves look like, so yeah. Those look kind of new. Well, that's what it looks like from the bottom of the head. And I'm gonna put it back because oil's starting to leak out. So if you wanna continue seeing what I'm doing with my Integra, rebuilding it, make sure to subscribe and all that stuff. Yeah, I'm gonna just be trying to consistently be uploading on what I'm doing for my car right now, since I'm not really good at posting that consistent, but I'll try my best till the car starts running again to see what everything I do, just in case it happens to you where you just blew your block or something. But yeah, this is where I'm gonna end it off. Later.